Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome. Grab your Happy Meals and hold on to your McNuggets because we're about to go on a McRoller coaster of an epic proportion as we take a deep dive into the slightly less than happy world of McDonald's. Don't forget to supersize your sense of humor. We're about to journey through a story that has more twists and turns than the secret recipe for the Big Mac special sauce. So buckle up and let's embark on this McAdventure together. In a realm of financial consultants, a new page-turning, popcorn-munching report has emerged, brought to us by the dynamic duo of the Franchise Consulting Group and VF Finance Consulting. The title is Ronald McDonald on His Deathbed. 30% of the franchisees are bankrupt or basically in the ICU. Paints a rather grim picture of the world's top-ranking fast food behemoth, McDonald's. For the first time in four decades, that's about the same time I've been trying to lose weight, my new McDonald's franchises are not loving it. They're facing bankruptcy, and they're unhappy as a burger without the bun. The report highlights how McDonald's management is trying to milk their franchisees for every penny they can get, despite these poor souls already grappling with the rising cost of not just the burger patties, but the lettuce, the buns, and don't even get me started on the pickles. Basically, they're being squeezed like a Big Mac inside of a Happy Meal box. Operating 95% of McDonald's spots in the good old U.S. of A, and generating roughly 70% of the revenue, these franchisees aren't enjoying the golden arches as much as they used to. The National Owners Association, possibly while munching on some chicken McNuggets, has calculated the cash flow for McDonald's restaurants in 2023 will be less generous than a diet plan. As if this wasn't bad enough, this could be like the deep-fried cherry on top for the already unstable franchise. Responding to the report, McDonald's agreed that inflation has been as unkind as a Happy Meal toy missing its head, slicing into the franchisee's profits. The executives defended the high operating costs like a knight in shining armor, claiming they're essential for the company's long-term supersize me goals. Franchisees, however, were less than pleased with the mounting cost and the new operating rules. They're planning to have a face-to-face with the company's board in hopes of conveying that they're cruising on a highway to the danger zone. The report reveals that some financiers have been frowning at the leadership's unpredictable and chaotic decisions, comparing them to McDonald's order gone wrong. One moment it's I'm loving it, the next moment it's where's the beef, said one financier. Another added, we're in a pickle, and it isn't the good kind if you find in a burger. Franchisees' discounts pose a risk to the McDonald's plan to supersize itself. John Gordon, principal at a Pacific Management Consulting Group, voiced concerns that if the unrest led to the old guard of franchisees flipping their last burgers, it would be as risky as a milkshake machine at McDonald's, which is to say, not functioning. The newbie franchisees would likely face high borrowing costs, making their profits as slim as fast food diet plan. The fast food landscape is looking increasingly bleak, with some franchisees fearing they're witnessing the last days of the iconic fast food empire. The report even suggests that McDonald's may be starting down a doomsday scenario worse than running out of ketchup. The prices for the burgers are hitting the roof, with some locations charging a whopping $8 for a Big Mac. That's like paying for a steak dinner at a five-star restaurant. Okay, maybe not, but it's a far cry from the $4.95 in 2020. Outrage has been flooding social media, with one user commenting, "Now I finally have a valid excuse for telling my kids we have food at home." As if the soaring prices and bankruptcy woes weren't enough, the report also throws light on another grim issue plaguing the McEmpire. Among them is several cases of McLabor scandals. As it turns out, more than 300 minors, including a couple of precocious 10-year-olds who have been deprived of their rightful Happy Meal toys, were found to be trolling away in a clear violation of federal labor laws at various McDonald's locations across Kentucky and many other states. The collective penalties that these franchisees are facing could ease amount to enough to make a supersized order of fries. The Labor Department Wage and Hour Division determined that these three separate franchises, operating 62 McDonald's locations across four different states, had let 305 kids clock in more than legally permitted hours and carry out tasks as illegal for them as a Diet Coke is for a Big Mac meal. Responding to these claims, Tiffany Boyd, Senior Vice President and Chief People officer at McDonald's USA, said, "This is unacceptable as asking for a hamburger at a vegan convention. We hold ourselves and our brand to the highest standards." On top of all this, there's seven more turbulence in the McUniverse. McDonald's is planning to close about 700 locations in 2023, including those found guilty of breaking labor laws, as well as underperforming stores that haven't been flipping as many patties as the company would like. The company brushed off concerns about the closures, saying, "We're so big, even if we lose a few stores, we're still king of the fast food world." However, for franchisees, it's like watching their favorite sitcom getting canceled. They're losing not just 700 stores, but their livelihoods as well. New legislation passed in both Virginia and California could potentially put over 1,600 more McDonald's restaurants in the danger zone. But despite all this, McDonald's isn't going down without a fight. McDonald's USA President Joe Erlinger hit back, saying the new legislation could cause a McRupture in the entire economy. He even warned that paying fast food workers such a wage would make dining at McDonald's as expensive as eating at a gourmet restaurant, causing many customers to rethink their fast food loyalty. So in summary, with the sky-high menu prices, a dwindling number of franchisees, allegations of child labor, and uncertain future, the golden arches aren't looking so golden after all. There's no doubt that the company is facing a supersized crisis, the one affordable and fast food chain seems to be transforming into a luxury that many Americans just can't afford. On the bright side, as we close out this roller coaster ride of a report, it looks like those New Year's resolutions to eat healthier might actually stick this time. After all, who can afford an $8 Big Mac? Keep that treadmill ready, folks, because we might be bidding goodbye to our beloved fast food giant. Thanks for joining us on this wild ride. And that, my friends, concludes our McSaga. It's been a journey with more bumps than a bag full of McNuggets. As the golden arches find themselves in a McPickle, let's hope they can hook up the strategies as appealing as a fresh hot fries. But remember, in the fast food world of ups and downs, not all that glitters is golden. Sometimes it's just grease from a cheeseburger. So stay tuned for the next episode of As the Burger Turns. In the meantime, remember to keep your sense of humor supersized, and may your dreams be filled with fewer fast food nightmares and more of those satisfying crispy hash browns. This is Survival Preparedness for Beginners. Stay safe, keep prepping. I'm out.